louder.
For he suffered many great things, and is incredibly miserable, has retreated to the wilderness in order to make himself feel better and wallow in his pain.
Oh, trippy, huh? That's hard beat. Bend your knees and then bring the sound, the contrast down. Now back up a little bit and continue with your lines.
Timon died at the end.
Louder.
Timon died at the end. And here is his epilogue, or sorry, his epitaph that he wrote himself for some reason.
Continue.
It's unclear really how he died. He just sort of died as if his pain was too much or Shakespeare had run out of use for him.
Oh, I love your improv. Keep it going.
To be honest, a lot of the stuff in Shakespeare narratively does not quite make sense. For instance, why did Romeo and Juliet fall in love so incredibly fast? Are we really supposed to believe that that was true love? Because it just sounds like a couple of stupid teenagers getting together.
Yeah, make it sinister.
Yeah, if you ask me, the man knew
hands
how to write,
behind you.
But his narratives did not always cohere, become cohesive.
And scene. Everyone give Jeremy a hand. That's
nice
what we're doing, people. We are lining up the actors. So Jeremy, Laura had an idea for Apomantis actually being red from the
stage.
Okay, Kevin.
Yeah, we were trying to figure it out the other day.
I'll just say funny things from the side.
All right, Liz, what do you think?